My name is Matthew Zowili, the chairman of Homa Bay County Civil Society Organizations Network. Today, during our quarterly meeting, we've come and we've already shared and agreed as Civil Society Organizations Network that one, the development of Homa Bay County CIDP 2023-2027 is a good step by Her Excellency the Governor. But now, we want to call upon the Office of the Governor to really take into account public participation into the CIDP. Under the mantra, nothing for us without us. There is nothing that can be done for the Homa Bay people without the inclusion of the voices of the Homa Bay people. And public participation is provided for, even if you look at the Public Finance Management Act, calls for people's voices. If you look at the Constitution of Kenya 2012, Article 1 starts by saying, we the people. So the power of the voice of the people is vested in there. And so we want to call upon the governor to ensure that people from the lowest unit, that is the villages, are involved in whatever is going to be there. I also want to call upon the assembly to ensure that they do a harmonious public participation together with the executive. In the past, there has been a problem where the executive conduct public participation, and when the assembly goes, then you find that there are changes in the proposals of the people. We want to call upon Homa Bay County to work as a unit so that there is harmony in the projects that the people identify. And finally, we want to call upon the assembly to pass the Civic Education and Public Participation Act, which will put into law, civic education and public participation policy to support the 2019 Homa Bay County Civic Education and Public Participation Act, so that it's put into law how structured way public participation should be done. Anyinga and Matthew.
We are encouraging the community of Homa Bay County to come out in large numbers and purposely at sub-location level to develop the third generation CIDP as it was kicked off at Kabunde. Let us this time have a cost-effective kind of public participation at sub-location level where each and everybody gives out his or her opinion, and from that one, the 16 people per sub-location will be selected to present their views at the ward level. So we are very extremely happy with the structure. And we think that for the first time, we are going to come with an evidence-based CIDP, which shall be also be tabled with ADP.
As a county, we are in the period of developing the CIDP, a five-year development plan for the county. And we are seeing it has started on a higher notch because in the sector working groups, we've seen a number of ladies, a number of women, a number of professionals, and we are so much grateful. For example, myself, I'm leading the sector of energy, infrastructure, and ICT, and we are calling upon the county government to also adopt such when it comes to giving out positions in terms of development in the sectors and various departments. We are grateful in the last list of nominations when CECs were being nominated. We are grateful the women have three chances. And we are also requesting the executive through Office of the Governor, so that while she'll be doing appointment of the chief officers, we are requesting that women be take the lead and not only men taking the higher side. Two, in the CIDP, we are also requesting that all the sectors to rope in women issues so that it's mainstreamed in all departments. And that when that is not done, then we shall be excluding women, but we do not want to do that. As a network, we are working towards inclusion. That is why we have the PWDs, we have the youth groups, also we have the NGOs. So as a network, we are crying out loud for the county government to also, while doing the appointments, they also include the PWDs. So thank you so much, and thank you.